Hello Year 4 and welcome to your geography lesson. This is great, isn't it, having these video lessons that we can work together on. And so fantastic work that you've done on your geography work over the last few weeks, finding out about landmarks around the world. And when before that, our world quiz, all that has been absolutely brilliant. And now what we're going to do is we're going to be able to work together on creating a snapshot of Brazil and really getting to know the country of Brazil a little bit better than maybe you already do. So what you will need is you will need a pen or pencil and some paper. And so I want you to get that ready. You can pause the video if you need to get those things, and then we'll be ready to carry on. Okay everyone, so here are some of the fantastic pieces of work that some of you did last week when we were learning about world landmarks. You can see the world landmarks, the Sydney Opera House, the Sphinx in Egypt, the Gombe National Park, the Great Wall of China, and the Statue of Liberty. And there was some fantastic work done last week. I wonder when you were finding out about the landmarks, whether or not you looked on the world map to find out where they would be, but there are the locations of some of the world famous landmarks: Great Wall of China, Stonehenge, Statue of Liberty, the Eiffel Tower in France, and the Great Pyramids. Okay, so today we're going to be finding out more about the country of Brazil and taking a bit more of a detailed look about that. And I would like you to just have a moment to think about what you already do know about Brazil. Do you know where Brazil is on the world map? Do you know which continent it's in? I wonder if you know the capital city of Brazil or anything about the natural features of the country. Any famous people from Brazil? Just stop the video and maybe make a note of what you already do know about Brazil on your piece of paper. Okay, so just a quick few facts before we get going. This monument is the statue called Christ the Redeemer, which stands high above the city of Rio de Janeiro. It looks out over the ocean and the bay, and there is a very crowded, densely populated city beneath it. And also Brazil is named after the Brazilwood tree. There it is. When we were looking for Brazil on the map, I wonder if you found it there in South America. It is the fifth largest country in the world. It has a long coastal border with the Atlantic Ocean and borders with 10 different countries. One challenge that you could take up today is to use an atlas and find out the names of all the countries that Brazil shares a border with. Okay, so what we're going to do today is we're going to do some research about Brazil. And in this video, you can listen and look at lots of information about Brazil. And I'd like you to make a note of it. Of course, you can carry out your own research using the internet as well, if you would like to. But these are the things that I'd like you to find out about. So I'd like you to take your piece of paper and pencil and make a note of the different things that we need to find out. So we've got the continent. We need to know where Brazil is, what continent it is in, capital city, the population, the climate, the currency, that's the kind of money they use, what the flag looks like, and the landmarks. So you can pause the video and just make a note on your piece of paper. Need to know about the language they speak. We need a heading for the Amazon rainforest. We need a heading for the people. Are they rich or poor? Are there any famous people that you can find out from Brazil? And any products and food from Brazil, and any sports? So if you can make your headings on your piece of paper, just pause the video until you're ready to carry on. Okay, so as I mentioned in the video, I'm going to be showing you and reading to you quite a lot of information about Brazil. So what you might like to do is pause the video when you want to, just to make a note on your piece of paper. You can also research using the internet if you would like to as well, or instead. Okay, so here we go. We're going to have a look at a few fast facts about Brazil. The population of Brazil is 196.6 million people. The capital city is Brasilia, and the largest city is Sao Paulo. The currency is the real, and the main religion is Catholicism. The official language of Brazil is Portuguese, although there are 180 indigenous languages spoken. Indigenous languages are the languages spoken by the indigenous people, and those are the people whose ancestors have always lived in Brazil, rather than those people who've moved from different areas of the world. So if you pause the video now, we've got quite a lot of facts there already that you can fill in on your piece of paper. Here's a picture of the Brazilian flag. In the middle of the flag is a blue globe with 27 stars. It might be quite good to find out the meaning of the flag and the words in the middle, Ordem e Progresso. Now, there is some information about the history of Brazil here. Brazil is the only Portuguese-speaking country in South America, and there's a reason for that. And it comes down to the explorers from Europe, from Spain and Portugal, who came over in their ships and wanted to take over and settle in the Americas. So people had come from Spain and Portugal, and they came up with a treaty, an agreement in 1494 that agreed to divide the Americas between Spain and Portugal. It was called the Line of Demarcation. In 1500, Portugal claimed possession of Brazil for itself. And you can see the name of the Portuguese fleet commander there, Pedro Alvarez Cabral. And this is why they speak Portuguese in Brazil. Now, actually, Brazil became an independent country in 1822, so quite a long time ago. However, the culture of Brazil is still mainly influenced by the Portuguese. Something we definitely would like to make notes on year four, that is the Amazon. Okay, so we're ready with your piece of paper. The Amazon is the largest river in the world, and of course, as we know, the Amazon rainforest is the largest tropical rainforest in the world. The Amazon rainforest covers more than 50% of the country. It's the world's largest jungle. Look at those fantastic animals. Very important for the health of the planet. And as we know, 20% of the Amazon has already been lost. Climate change and deforestation could mean another 20% of the forest may disappear by 2035. So pause the video and just make a few brief notes about the Amazon rainforest. The climate of Brazil, I wonder if you can remember the climate zone. Okay, so the climate zone of Brazil is the tropical zone, where the tropical rainforests are. As you can see, in summer in December and winter in June, extremely hot in the summer. Okay, so we're looking at the people of Brazil now and where they come from, their ancestries, looking back through generations of families. And about 60% of the country's population are of European ancestry. So their families originally came from Germany, Italy, Portugal and Spain. Afro-Brazilians make up about 7%, and Amerindians, the original Brazilians, they form less than 1% of the Brazil's people today. That seems quite surprising, doesn't it? Many Brazilians have mixed ancestry. We wanted to know whether people were rich and poor, and Brazil is a wealthy country, but the gap between the richest and the poorest people is one of the biggest in the world. About 40 million people live in poverty. That's about 1 in 5 Brazilian people. In the Sao Paulo, the largest city in Brazil, there are 17.5 million people. So it's very, very crowded. And whereas there are 30,000 millionaires in Sao Paulo, there are 3.5 million people there living in poverty and 15,000 on the streets. Okay, moving on then to carnivals. You can see a picture here of the carnival in Rio de Janeiro. It's the greatest and most celebrated festival in Brazil. This is 4 days of singing and dancing and music played by these enormous samba bands of drums and singers. The carnival in Rio de Janeiro is a world famous festival held before Lent every year and considered the biggest carnival in the world, with 2 million people per day on the streets. The first festivals of Rio date back to 1723. A typical Rio carnival parade is filled with revelers, that's people having fun, floats, costumes and adornments, feathers and all sorts. From samba schools in the city, it's actually a really big competition between the different samba schools in the city, and those samba bands will have practiced for a full year for that carnival. Brazilian trade. So we're really getting to the end now, so you might like to think of which products come from Brazil. Brazil is the largest coffee producer in the world. It's also the world leader in the production of livestock. We talked about cattle ranching, didn't we, when we were talking about deforestation, how it was threatening the rainforest. There are also many mines in Brazil mining minerals and steel. So let's have a look at some of the natural resources, iron ore, manganese, also crops that are grown, products such as coffee, bananas, cacao beans, cattle, cotton, horses, lemon, maize, oranges. You can see lots and lots there. And it's helped make Brazil a growing economic power. And some famous Brazilian food. Brazil's national dish combines black beans, dried beef and pork, feijoada, and then, these look nice. It's a chocolate fudge snack, very popular, called a brigadeiro. Coffee is Brazil's chief drink. And Brazilians also like batidas, sweet fruit beverages made with rum. Okay. And I think, well done everybody, we've got to the end of all that information about Brazil. So hopefully we feel like we know quite a lot about that country now. You might want to carry on and find out even more, perhaps about famous people from Brazil or their sports, and note those down on your piece of paper again. You might like to draw the flag and colour that in, and maybe do some research about what that flag means, as we mentioned earlier. But you have been absolutely brilliant. I would love to see your research on Seesaw, and I hope you enjoy finding out about Brazil. Well done. Yeah.